And the thing about promise is that promise often needs an activator, because promise will lay dormant until some circumstance activates the promise that's in you. There are some of us that know that we had the potential to do the things we did until there was some circumstance, some situation, some challenge, some dilemma that activated the potential that's inside of us. I'm just trying to see if I got some folk of promise in here, some folk that understand that you have potential in you, and you know how to thank God for the opportunities that woke up potential that you didn't even know you had until the circumstance showed up in your life. You didn't know that you could figure out how to do accounting until you had to step up to the plate in the middle of a fight. And then all of a sudden you flunked calculus growing up, but now you can do DFQ because a situation forced a, I'm not on your street yet. You didn't know that you could turn two fish and five loaves of bread into enough to feed 5,000 until all of a sudden you had more month than you had money, and you began to sit there and pray over it. You brought your tithe into the house of the Lord, and the Lord began to multiply your fish and bread, and you fed five children like you were living. Am I talking to anyone? Is there the enemy doesn't understand that often what he sends to us is the very thing that wakes up the potential of God in us. Yeah. You thought this was going to take my fight, but really what this did was wake up a fight in me that I didn't even realize I had. I didn't know I could sing like this till somebody started tripping. I didn't know I could preach like this until somebody started talking about my family. I didn't know that I could work like this until somebody said that I don't have the right degree. But because the enemy would set his voice against me and try to put his hand up against me, he woke up something in me that would help me to understand there was a potential that I didn't even know I had. I dare you to give somebody a high five and tell them I got something in me that I didn't even know I had. There's an anointing in me, but it's activated by the circumstances of life. That's the reason Paul said it this way, that we are to glory in tribulation. He says in Romans, he says, now I want you to glory in tribulation, because tribulation builds perseverance. In other words, I didn't know I could persevere until the tribulation comes. So now I got to learn how to glory in the tribulation. So when it gets crazy, my praise intensifies, because the word says I should glory in tribulation. Why? Because tribulation builds my perseverance. I dare you to tap yourself and say, I got perseverance. Come on and tap yourself and say, I'm anointed to be tough. Come on and speak it. Say, I'm anointed to be tough. I can persevere. I got a praise that works even in the face of problems. I'm anointed to be tough. I got a hallelujah that works even when I got hell going on around me. I'm anointed to be tough. I don't know where we get all these weak and fickle Christians from. The first time something don't go their way, they run like a little puppy with the tail tucked between their legs. But I need some warriors in here to tap yourself and say, I'm anointed to be tough. Oh God. So I glory in tribulation, because tribulation builds perseverance, and perseverance builds character. Oh God, character now is the anointing to be tough, because character is what you do even when folks are not looking. It takes a tough anointing to say, I'm still gonna live right, even though by anybody, even though no one will find out what I do. I'm just trying to see if there's someone that will open your mouth and say, I'm anointed to be tough. I'm trying to get past this thing, but something in me gets moving me. I need some tough folk in here. I dare you one more time, speaking and say, I'm anointed to be tough. You're gonna go back on that job tomorrow and you will not cry. You will not contemplate turning in your resignation, because you are anointed to be tough. You will not walk off of that job. You will not give up on that business. You will not let go of that promise because you are anointed to be tough. We're the folk that's got the character to stand tough. Hallelujah. The word says it builds character, and character builds hope. And in that hope, there is no disappointment because the promises of God are yes and amen. When God makes a promise, that promise is already sealed by the word of God. That's the reason you just got to hang tough until the promise comes to pass in your life. I wonder if there's anybody that knows his promises are yes and amen. Oh God, now for your promise people, then we must recognize that the promise does not come without process. There is a process. There is an internal process, and then there is an external process. There is now a process that pushes us towards the promise.